And they're away. Round one, Master A. Keirin, round one. That's James McLean, Milton Bicycle Club, taking the front position. Four laps to go. We got four laps to go for this round one heat. Three to go, half a lap for the journey. Journey pulls off. And James McLean still on the front. Two laps to go. Into the home stretch, and the bell's ringing for these guys. Let's hear it for them. Looks like James McLean, followed by Enrico Traiani. And David Hinnish. James McLean takes heat number one, heat number two. Features Chris Dunbar, Matt DeLuco, Matt Butchewitz, Alex Hantumakos, and Enoch Tse. Thank you. Only three riders for the second heat of the Master A Keirin round one event, so all three advance. We move on to the women's Keirin. Master women's Keirin, 1-6 final, 8 laps. Featuring Rosa Phillip, Midweek Cycling Club. Stephanie Nogueira from Milton, Ontario. Agatha Pezd, Kurzawinski coach. Petrina Tulisi from Oakville. Vlada Dekina, racing for Kurzawinski coach out of Milton. Shauna Atkins, Kurzawinski coach rider, and Heather Kelly are racing for midweek, all underway now. We'll go for a restart there. Looking for a neutral mechanic, someone to assist. Attention, Master B men. Master B men involved in the 1-6 Keirin final. Report to bike track. Master B men in the Keirin 1-6 final. Please report to bike track as we have our women's 1-6 final resetting. Journey is on its way. Here we go. Everybody's lining up. Vlada Dekina, Kurzawinski coach, bike zone rider, takes up first position. With six laps to go, looks like we got a nice setup for an amazing final for these master women. Vlada Dekina tucked in behind the Derny. Showing four laps to go. Three laps showing for the riders, half a lap for the Derny. Let's hear it for this championship final, first through sixth. Off goes the Derny, and now it's up to the women. Pulling through is rider 167, Petrina Tulisi. One lap to go as Vlada Dekina Kurzawinski opens it up, goes over top of Petrina, opens a gap, and now the riders are chasing hard. Quarter lap to go into the home stretch. Well, what a race as Vlada Dekina comes in a clear first, and too tight for me to call for second and third. I'll wait for the official results. Well, there you have it. Vlada Dekina Kurzawinski, first place. Rosa Philip, second. Agata Pest in third place. Midweek Cycling Club sandwiched between Kurzawinski. Master CD Men's Keirin, 1-6 final, next up. Schneider, Smart, Ugald, Kurzawinski, Cormier, and Kinningham look to be ready. Derny is on its way. Richard Ugald making haste. He wanted that first position behind the Durney. Slides in there comfortably as everybody else tees up behind. Seven laps to go as Richard Ugald gets to the front, holds that position behind the Durney. Showing five laps to go. And as the pace quickens, we're now at four to go. Showing three, half a lap for the Durney. Durney pulls off. Richard Ugald looking over his shoulder, going up the bank a little bit, relinquishing the sprinter's line. And now Kurzawinski rider number 60, Schneider, takes to the front and opens up a sizable gap, leaving it to the rest to chase. The bell rings, one lap to go. One lap to go for Christian Schneider, if he could hold on. Schneider, and it looks like 69, Krzysztof Kurzawinski, just nipping out a rider for the silver medal. Final results, Christian Schneider, Kurzawinski, Krzysztof Kurzawinski racing for Kurzawinski, and in third place, Richard Ugald racing for La Bicicleta. This event underway, it's the Master B Men's Keirin 1-6 final. Ford, Camilleri, Furyk, D'Angelo, and Wright on the track. And it's Andy D'Angelo, Krzywinski coach, taking up the lead just behind the Durney in the opening lap. Showing four laps to go. Camilleri still at the front. Correction. Apologies, D'Angelo on the front, just behind the Durney. And as the Durney pulls off, D'Angelo decides to stay at the front. No one committing to the sprinter's line. Now the bell goes and D'Angelo takes off. Unbelievable. What a thing to see, ladies and gentlemen, as Andy D'Angelo pulls a foot, keeps it upright, and manages to hang on for third place. Not to draw attention away from Matthew Ford and Gary Wright, taking first and second, but D'Angelo, the story of that 1-6 final for the Master B men.
That's amazing.
Please call U17 men.
U17 men. U17 men, please report to bike check for your 1-6 final in the Keirin. U17 men in the 1-6 final for the Keirin, report to bike check as our under 17 women take to the track for their under 17 women's Keirin 1-6 final featuring Madonna Wheeler's Cycling Club rider Emma Archbold, Victoria Slater racing for NCCH, Cassandra Kriarakis for Callisto, Zoe Wolfers racing for Callisto, Julia Gibson for the Ottawa Bike Club, and Marcy Bardman for Sprinter's Edge as the Durney gets underway. Nice clean start as Emma Archibald shows haste and gets right behind the Durney. Obviously a strategy she wishes to employ as the other women line up behind. Jockeying for position behind. Emma solidly behind the Durney, no worries for her. Thank you. showing six laps to go. Pace picks up. We're showing five laps to go, and Emma Archbold comfortably behind the Durney. Four to go. Showing three laps to go for the women, half a lap for the Durney, then it's all up to the riders. Off goes the Durney, Emma Archbold pulls up. New front rider. Ottawa rider, 191, Julia Gibson, overtaken now. Coming in for the bell, out of the saddle at the front. Rider 192 opening it up, Marcy Bardman, Sprinter's Edge. And it looks like Bardman followed by Gibson. Bardman, Gibson, Slater, Kriariakis, Archbold, and Wolfers. Under 17, Keirin, 1-6 final features Campbell, Correa, Delterio, Dominguez, Flegel Bray, and Harrison. Durney is on its way. Justin Correa looking comfortable behind the Derny. Justin Correa, Callisto. Showing six to go. Into the home stretch and four laps to go for this, the under 17 men's Keirin 1-6 final. As the pace picks up, Derny has one more lap, and then it's up to the men on the track. Showing three to go. And now it's up to these under 17 men to finish it off for two laps. Quebec going over the top. Correa not letting him go. The bell indicates one lap to go. Here they go now. Right at 1:15, Antoine Del Terrio. And Carrera goes over the top into the final two turns. Carrera Del Terrio. Too close to call. Could be Joel Dominga, Equipe de Quebec, nipping for third. We await the official results. There it is, Justin Correa, Callisto, first place, Antoine Del Terrio in second, and Joel Dominga in third. Third place, bronze medal to Oliver Campbell. Silver medal, correction, for Campbell. Next up, junior women's Keirin 1-6 final. Ali Van Eisendorn and Naomi D'Souza and Charlotte Creswick for Callisto, Eva Burke for Sprinter's Edge, and Amelia Bell and Hillary Lowry for NCCH in this junior women's final. And as they head out right onto the Derny, This should prove to be a very interesting final for our junior women in this provincial championship. Eva Burke choosing to take the front position for her Sprinter's Edge team. Master A men's Keirin 7 through 12 finals to the bike chat. All Master A men in the 7 through 12 Keirin final to the bike chat. Four laps to go, four showing on the lap board. Showing three laps, half a lap for the Durney. Rider 159, Eva Burke still on the front. And as the Durney pulls off, the women crank it up. No hesitation. Come in for the bell, and rider 156, Naomi D'Souza, challenging Eva Burke. She's not giving up. Naomi D'Souza digging. And it looks to me like Naomi D'Souza, Callisto, takes it right at the line. What a race. What a charge for the finish. Results, Naomi D'Souza, Callisto taking the gold medal. Amelia Bell hiding at the back most of the race. National champion from National Cycling Center Hamilton taking the silver. Eva Burke taking third in the race, but Charlotte Creswick, Callisto taking the bronze medal in these provincial championships. Junior men's 1-6 final, Keirin Drapeau-Zgorowski, Chris Ernst, Jilland Sidney, Lucas Taylor, Justin Butsavage, and Adam Lefebvre on the track. Master A men, Keirin 7-12 final to bike chat, and Master women to bike check as well. Master women to bike chat. Journey coming around. J junior men rolling. Quite a few like-minded riders in terms of strategy sorting themselves out now as they come around. Lap number one will show seven laps to go. Master Amen for the Keirin to the track, please. Master Amen, Keirin to the track, as our junior men make their way up the backstretch. Six laps showing as rider 84 sitting on the front, G-Lan Sydney. All women in the points race to bike check, please. Women's points race entrance to the bike check. Four laps showing as Jillian Sydney still on the front, right behind the Durney. Three laps to go. The Durney should pull off in the backstretch. And now it's up to these men going three abreast into the home stretch with two to go. Justin Butsavage leads it out. One lap to go. And over the top, rider 85, looks like Lucas Taylor. Lucas Taylor putting in the final dig. Lucas Taylor coming around the final turn. And Lucas Taylor, Callisto for a City Velodrome presented by Toyo Tires, taking the gold medal in this junior men's Keirin 1-6 final. Great race for Callisto. Lucas Taylor takes the gold, G-Lan Sydney, silver medal, and Chris Ernst takes the bronze, a Callisto sweep in the junior men's Keirin. Sounds like we're going to have a couple minutes to review some video. Riders are being released to roll around, stay loose. Master A riders back to the line. Final review of the video sees rider number 84 relegated for dangerous riding during his race. Rider number 84 relegated for dangerous riding during the race. Calling the Master A, Keirin, 1-6 final riders back to their start. We'll be looking for Chris Dunbar, David Hennish, Matt DeLuco, and for Callisto Forest City Velodrome, Enrico Triani. Alex Hantumakos. And for the Milton Bicycle Club, James McLean. journey getting underway. Alex Hantumakos hustling to the journey. Everyone else jockeying for position. Junior men's Keirin 1-6 final. Rider number 84, Jeland Sydney, Callisto Forest City Velodrome, presented by Toyo Tires, has been relegated to sixth place for dangerous riding during the race. Official results will be posted shortly. Showing five laps to go, and Alex Hantumakos looking very smooth, very calm, right behind the journey. Four laps to go. Three laps to go, half a lap for the journey, onto the backstretch. Off goes the journey, and now it's up to the men and their bikes. I mean, three abreast through the home stretch. Two to go. Enrico Traiani takes to the front. Coming back onto the home stretch, the bell indicates one lap to go. Enrico Traiani, gritting teeth. Rider number 25, Matt DeLuco on his wheel. Into the sprinter's line and to the finish. Traiani, DeLuco, and rider 24, David Hainish, comes in for third place. What a race. Final results, Enrico Traiani, Callisto in first place, gold medalist. Matt DeLuco, silver medal. And David Hainish, bronze medal for our Master A men's Keirin. Next up, women's Keirin. Featuring Julia Sant from the United States, racing for Sprinter's Edge. Sarah Mason for Rise Racing. Mackenzie Brown for Sprinter's Edge. Team Novo Nordisk rider Mandy Marquardt is in this mix, and representing Callisto Forest City Velodrome, presented by Toyo Tires, Candice Moot. And they're underway. Rider 150, Candice Moot, showing a little hustle to get behind the Derny. Riders opting for different strategies depending on their skill sets. Candice obviously wanting that Derny position, front of the pack. Definitely has its advantages. Candice Moot from Beamsville, Ontario, racing for Callisto at the front of this group. And as the pace quickens, we'll show three laps to go for the riders, just half a lap for the Derny. Candice Moot solidly in place. And now it's up to the women as the Derny pulls off. Action over top already. Two laps to go for these women as rider 143 takes to the front. Mackenzie Brown, Candice Moot on her wheel. And now the rest of the women reacting. Mackenzie Brown, one lap to go. Mackenzie Brown on the front. And into the sprinter's line comes rider 147, Mandy Marquardt, Team Novo Nordisk, takes the win. Three American riders in that 1-6 final. That means, depending on where Sarah Mason and Candice Moot finished, we have our gold and silver medalist. There are the results. Marquardt, Sant, Brown, Candice Moot, gold medal for Callisto, and Sarah Mason for Rise Racing takes the silver. One last, Keirin, the men's first through sixth place final, featuring La Bicicleta riders Scott Liberté and Steve McKee, Sprinter's Edge rider Jamie Alvord, Team Race Clean, represented by Bailey Simpson, and Redbeard Racing has Evan Thompson in this 1-6 final for the men. Jamie Alvord selecting the Derny position. Four laps showing. Showing three laps, half a lap for the Derny. Here we come into the home stretch, showing two laps to go for these men. One lap to go, Jamie Alvord out of the saddle, cranking it out into the back stretch. Jamie Alvord, Steve McKee, and Evan Thompson, I believe, but we'll wait for the official posting of results. Spectacular, gentlemen, spectacular race. Well done. A wave from Jamie Alvord, the race winner. That was our last Keirin for this session. Big hand for these guys. Best entertainment in town.